Okay. In this game, it's Thresh versus Mordekaiser, and again, going with the on-hit tanky build. In this game, the top, jungle, and mid of my team get pretty fed. The enemy Mordekaiser causes havoc, Vayne gets fed, and, well, we just kind of try to play around that, try to do the best we can. So going with the tanky build, I'm going to be very team-fighty, very peely, and able to kind of like face tank and dive. Unlike the other build, which I'm going to be uploading soon, or might have already uploaded when this goes up, where you go like full AD. Anyway, the runes should go up on the screen. If they don't, put it in the comments below, I'm sure I'll remember for next time. But for this one, we are running Aftershock and Bone Plating, or it might be Conditioning. Yeah, we got Conditioning, actually. And we got Aftershock because Mordekaiser is scary. Here, Mordekaiser goes a bit too close, so I'm able to get one tower shot on him. And I don't think that's enough to get a kill at this point. I could flash, but there's no flay to follow up. And then, yeah, I don't think I've got Ignite either. I've got Exhaust on because our support doesn't have Exhaust. And I'm, again, pretty scared of the Morde. I'm hoping to get some Exhaust on him before he goes into Shadow Realm. Or getting them just on Vayne, getting them on Diana before she bursts. And, yeah. Anyway, Nocturne comes in for the gank. Unfortunately, there's a lot of minions on the line here. So I decided to go kind of all in. And we get the kill. That's so it's not that bad that I missed my cannon there. But yeah, Mordekaiser TP's back, so we get his flash. We trade flashes and all that. Trade summoners. So back to just being kind of even. Let me put that down. For the most part, if you're able to dodge Mord's two skill shot, so his Q AoE and his E AoE pull, then you're in. You're probably going to be fine. Anyway, these guys come in, and I'm trying to bait them closer to the tower, but they're able to just get away anyway. I could have probably flayed a bit, like, kind of instantly, just to get the aftershock and take less damage, but I still had a potion, so it was kind of okay. But for the most part, I'm just trying to farm as much as I can. Once again, get the armor to be as tanky as I can to Lee and Vayne, whilst I build like Wit's End and Magic Resist to stand up to Mord, Diana, and Lux. I'm just trying to keep in this neutral game, for, I guess, for as long as I can. That's how I'm able to, you know, win with a lantern gank or something. Being really defensive. One misstep means I get ganked and killed. You can even see, because we got the Fog of War off, that Lee Sin was planning to gank there. But I'd say one of my prime priorities, really, besides, you know, helping with ganks like this one, he kind of 1v1s him while I've got the big wave. And that did use Mord's ult, by the way. So one of the big things I try to do is make sure that I'm at least defending my plates. So I don't really roam until the plates are gone, especially against someone who can push like Mord, unless I've, you know, put him in the dirt, pushed him like 10 times over, and he can't like push back. In the case of, I don't know, someone like someone who can't push, of which I can't think of one at the moment. Someone like Quinn, I suppose. Anyway, so we got pickaxe for the early AD. Early AD, even if you're not building like a full AD rapid fire cannon build, is still good for like poking in the early game. I think it might not be the most appropriate thing for this. I could have just skipped it entirely, but it will go into Rageblade later, and then I get the Wit's End, sorry, the No Magic Mantle going into Wit's End, and the two daggers going into either item, depending how the game goes. Bit of a trade there, which I just sped over. We got a TP from Aatrox trying to come in, but Mord flashes out. So in the end of the day, yeah, nothing really happens there, but Nocturne's able to squeeze a solo dragon in there, so that's our advantage. Aatrox kind of camps for a little bit, but Mord is a little too careful, and so nothing really happens. Both junglers are in the top side. I think I'm in a death realm here. It's kind of unclear in replays, but yeah, let me try not to speed past everything here. So I go a bit close to the minion, and then Lantern shield myself against Mord. As soon as he gets his free stack, he goes ahead and ults. And now a funny thing happens here. I die here. But still in the death realm. And then I think I try to Q. Yep. But see how it just kind of does nothing? Yeah, so apparently if a projectile is in the death realm, and when the death realm ends, then the projectile will just kind of die. And Thresh's Q, despite being a chain, like, linked to him, obviously, It doesn't count. It does count as a projectile, sorry. So yeah, try not to Thresh Q or use any kind of projectile at the end of Death Realm. I think there might be some kind of a buff timer or debuff timer on that you can visually see. But yeah, I'm going to do that quite a few times this game because I don't quite understand it until a bit later on. But yeah, until then, it's just kind of a frustrating thing to deal with. And yeah, I'm not sure I would have, you know, gotten a kill out of that if the hook landed, but I could have, maybe we could have both died or something. That's in my happy little headcanon of how this game could have gone, I guess. Anyway, Nocturne's waiting for a gank. He's got his ult ready. Okay, he used his ult, but he didn't use his ult. Oh, yeah, because I went to Death Realm. Again, it's really hard to see. And again, I tried to land a Q on him whilst he's trying to, like, escape. And then, all abilities in Death Realm would just be gone. Says Mordekaiser. As far as opinions go on the new Mordekaiser, I really like him. I did like old Mordekaiser as well, not as much as some people clearly, but yeah, I think he's quite fair. I think the Death Realm's fair. You can use Quicksilver Sash to get rid of the Death Realm, by the way. So if you're an AD carry or anything like that, then I highly recommend getting one against Mord. Kind of how you would get rid of it against Skarner, against Mel'Zahar, maybe Warwick. So yeah. So yeah, lane just keeps going. There's occasionally trades, occasionally ganks, but for the most part, we're just farming, and that's how I like to play Thresh. Just farming a lot, and playing fairly safe. And if an advantage presents itself, then I'll go for it. Turret plating now has gone down, so I'm a bit more free to roam. It looks like Mordekaiser is also free to roam. He is. Where is Mord? Oh, he recalled. So yeah. Just proccing that demolish. We got the cannon wave, so I'm just chucking that tower. Chucking, I don't know what I mean by that. Doing as much damage to that tower as I can. Don't know if I could have got the plate in there. Mordekaiser does have ult, so yeah, I would have probably just died. Yeah, after a little roam, I go back to top. More souls, more farming. And yeah, whenever he gets into like a trade that I don't want to be in, I'll immediately both to get him off me and to get the aftershock resistances. And you know, if I can, aftershock damage. Especially if I'm trying to, you know, engage on him because I've got an advantage. So when I went back, I got my Wit's End because I've got a Diana, a Mordekaiser, and there's a lot of damage that you can't really dodge here. Like, you know, Mordekaiser's passive is pretty big. And sometimes in the midst of a team fight, you're just going to end up being hit by Mord's Q. You can't really dodge it when you're trying to get on Vayne or something. So the magic resist will do a lot. Anyway, Karma comes for a gank, and I try to tell her no. As you can see, Thresh, because you want to be careful, because there's nothing, like absolutely nothing, that I can do when she gets Mord ulted. I just about Duke Lux, and I do waste an ult there. I'm able to get Lux because, she's going a bit far. I don't think she has a... Yeah, she took Comet. She hasn't got Aftershock. The meta right now is kind of for Lux to take Aftershock so she can compete with tankier supports. And if she gets caught by like a Pike Hook or a Thresh Hook, then she can just Q and, you know, gets plenty of resistances and doesn't have to die. So, yeah. Now with Diana here, Nocturne goes straight in, tries to get a Fear off. I think we're still waiting on that Fear, actually. I take the Lee Sin Q. And just try to kite away as quickly as I can so I don't die. Duke the Elise NQ again. And then there we go. There's four of us top with a severe, I think, dead. And then, with my Lantern Shield, my Aftershock, I can quite confidently go ahead and pick Lux up there with the hook. Anyway, now that team fights are starting to happen, I take my Merc Treads because Lux Q... And just general magic damage overall, and my Jarum Assist so I can have a bit more health and just not, you know, get insta-bursted by Mord or insta-bursted by Lee, Diana especially, now that she's getting a couple kills. And then, then that Rage Blade can be built and then I can have damage and then I can just go full tank after that. Relatively, anyway. I always call him Bruiser Thresh, but that doesn't really get as much attention as calling him AED Thresh or, you know, Top Thresh or whatever. For whatever reason, anyway. Now with enemy top tower taken, it's very easy for me to just roam about. Nocturne's trying to sneak in with a dragon, I think. Yeah, he's alone. And if I just take the camera for a second here, I'm behind them, I buy their backline. Lee Sin does the best ult of all time, sending Nocturne straight into Vayne. Unfortunately, he is able to get the kill because of the intense burst. I miss my flay on Vayne, but we're able to get her anyway because she's just that low. And a very satisfying Aatrox second Q catches those two. Although he does miss the third Q. Oh no, he doesn't, sorry. Got confused by the animations. And then we get a bunch of kills, and I think we get a dragon. Do we? No, we don't. I don't know. We're in, equal on Infernal, so whatever. Again, you function as a tank when you build like this, so you are the front line. You are to go in, you are to dive on the enemy and deal damage. So yeah, you're like a bruiser, you're a tank. You can, depending, one, how many souls you have and how defensive you've itemized. Like, I could have traded that pickaxe and a little more gold for a giant's belt and gone to a faster frozen mallet and been tankier. Anyway, Karma gets pointed at by Mordekaiser, so she just kind of dies. Whereas we have no ability to help her whatsoever. Especially with the rest of the team there. Aatrox gets caught a little bit. Vayne is very strong. Try to get some damage on her, but true no avail. Plenty of good plays and end with us dead. Mordekaiser E's and Diana W's, I think it is. I think it's her W. Could be wrong. That might be the shield. Is it the Diana pool? I've never played Diana. Maybe I played her once, I can't remember. But yeah, now I got Frozen Mallets, ignoring my Rage Blade for a little bit just because I need to be a bit tankier so I don't die like I just did then. And can be a bit more useful. Of course, Frozen Mallet has its passive, which is kind of useful as well. It means if you're in auto attack range, you can slow them and probably land a Q, you know, probably land a Flay, or just, you know, perma slow. It's always good. More team fights going on here with Nocturne going in on people, Aatrox going in on people, and me going to top lane. That's so I can get more souls and farm. I'm currently at 99 souls, which is about 75 armor. And at 26 minutes in the game, this is fairly decent. I have had 100 souls as early as like 23 minutes, but that is like special games where you get plenty of kills, plenty of farm. So yeah, more fights going on here. I try to throw a lantern, but it doesn't really happen. Vayne just kind of gets ignored, so she's able to live, and then by the time I get there, everything is just going badly. So I go back to circle around mid lane, and then prepare to defend the inner turrets, because there's no way we can defend the outer one. Like, severe soak up the farm. She takes a bit of burst from Lux. I get a tower shot onto Morde, and we're able to reduce him to about a quarter health. But at the right now, the enemy team is much in the advantage. They got a 9-2-5 Vayne, and the rest of the team is not doing too bad. Some of them might be a bit negative, but overall not that bad. We're not doing too badly either, but, you know, a big Vayne and heading towards a, you know, 30-minute mark with no sign of us of the game being quite closed out yet is always a bad sign. Anyway, I split push top because I know that the enemy is all over the place. Let's change it to my vision, shall we? Yeah. And then whilst they're all heading to top to deal with me, my team is able to like get a collapse, another Nocturne ult. This Aatrox plays very well. But then we have to back off. I get the hook on Diana, but kind of defensively flay and box it so we don't have to like overcommit. Whilst Nocturne kind of 1v1s Mord, which probably isn't going to go very well if he can't juke stuff and spell shield stuff. We go ahead and get the kill on Lee Sin. We come back from Mord, but Mord's already kind of long gone. Aatrox does go in on him, but he's able to flash. And then Diana, rather tanky Diana, mind you, comes in, and we're able to finish her off. I end up pretty low, and there's pretty much nothing I can do. Yeah, I just kind of die. And then Aatrox could have gotten the kill if he didn't pussy out there. But now he's going to get baited. You see that resource bar there? That's Mordekaiser's shield, which you can activate whenever. Now he's dead, and he doesn't auto attack with the heal, so it's like, ooh, that sucks. And, yeah. It might have been sped up, but that's about as fast as it seemed in-game as well. Karma just kind of dying here and there. She's at 9 deaths currently. Yeah, more farming, more pushing, more souls. Getting tankier. Now I've got my Rage Blade, so my damage is pretty respectable against the entire enemy team with their pen as well. one thing I could have gotten was Blade Rune King. So Aatrox gets Mord ulted, and nothing seems to come out of it. And in amidst the stalemate, Siv is able to get top. And we get poked. Karma gets poked down, so we just there's no advantage here. Vayne just kind of gets ignored, and I believe she has Runan's Hurricane, which does not proc Silver Bolts, but it certainly procs Blade Rune King. And we kind of get... Yeah, we take heavy damage here. I kind of greedily go in on the Lee Sin. I'm not even able to get him, so that's just kind of sad. And I die, and Aatrox... is he able to get away? No. As you can see, things aren't going particularly well, amazingly. The enemy gets another mountain, so we're now at equal on mountains and infernals. And once again, they've got a vein, so things are looking hugely in their favour. Luckily, my souls are going up, and I'm getting a Spectre's Cowl because I realise I'm going to end up sitting in Maud's damage, I'm going to end up sitting in Diana's damage, and I'm just going to need to be able to tank through it. Yep. All dancing around Baron, a bit anxious as to what can happen here. Nocturne pushes mid, while the rest of them just kind of skirmish. And I just kind of do nothing for now. Just hovering about, waiting for some kind of fight to break out. Diana's pushing top, so Nocturne goes to deal with her. Send her away. And he does. And amidst all this, especially with Nocturne's up, active, and people fighting Aatrox, we're able to get the inhibitor. Vayne just kind of hovering around, waiting for her team to show up and save the day. Whereas, Aatrox is able to keep all of them away. He just tried to heal with passive, but he just kind of dies. Karma paths terribly, not with no map awareness, knowing that they were there. Ayelanta and Tivir away because, screw Karma, she can get away by herself. That was my messenger, by the way. And then we come up top to just kind of deal with Diana. And enemy takes Baron. So again, things really aren't looking good. And Aatrox calls out GG, like, oh no, we're going to lose. Siv's got QSS in case she gets Mord ulted. She's got three full items now and Zerka's boots, so she's going to do pretty good damage. Whereas Vayne's build is weird. I don't agree with that at all. And I do play Vayne sometimes. So yeah. Coming back for another team fight, I now have 150 magic resist, 160 armor, considering I have not bought any armor, that is pretty damn good. And hoping to get in there and do my job as a tank at some point. Currently Aatrox is split pushing top, and he has had to back off because of Diana. So we're just kind of defending while he does his thing. Now he TPs on the tower, but the TP dies. So he's just left there, I believe, with Diana. And then he runs away to join the mid-team fight. Only they all saw him coming and they were trying to catch him. And again, we're just in a kind of a stalemate while the enemy has Baron for a little bit. Siv gets caught, so I shield her with W. Vayne gets picked by Nocturne and Aatrox, which is good. So we're able to just finish off these guys. I miss a hook, which is kind of sad. But it's not like I did, literally nothing. We call out Elder Dragon. Go and get that so we can get double Infernal, double Mountain. And then we recall it so we can buy items. I've got my Spirit Visage, which is a lot more magic resist. It buffs the healing from my Wit's End, which isn't much. It's only 33% because I'm ranged. But it's definitely something, and extra regen is always good when you're a tank. So I push top, so it will end up pushing, as you can see. And then, I think so. Yep. And then rejoin the fight. So top will just kind of push whilst we're able to do something here. Get the hook on Lee, aiming for Vayne, and then I walk over to, aim for Lux, and then I walk over to Vayne, we're able to catch her with the flay, and then she gets killed in the Nocturne ult while he just kind of finishes Lee off, and we try to chase Diana. Diana just kind of goes in, and there's enough Aatrox knockups and Azonias to allow me to pick her off with... keep her CC'd with flame, then she's able to ult away onto Aatrox just for her to die again. From here, we're able to get the inhibitor again. And then I think rotate. Karma's just doing Karma things and pushing. Baron's spawning, so we go back and get that. The enemy has no real ability to respond because of the inhib, and it looks like they have no vision. No vision at all. So yep, recall and grab a couple more items. That's going to be the glacial shard going into Frozen Heart, which I don't need. And CDR, of course, amazing on Thresh. It's just that the on-hit build doesn't really have much space for it, so items like Frozen Heart, Spirit of Visage are very welcome. Of course, Adaptive Helm is equally as welcome. Vayne on the side. So I looked for a catch. Aatrox is pushing bot, so we can just kind of, you know, dawdle about mid, not engaging like that. Well, Aatrox pushes. So I'm not doing much, but just me being here means that the enemy can't really just, you know, engage and kill us all. Thresh has got amazing disengage after all. Anyway, Aatrox is now pushing this and getting away with it. Vayne goes down to deal with him, and I believe so does Diana. So I say, Hail, let's go in. I hook him and all that. Mord, I think, hooks me, which is his mistake. And then we're able to get a bunch of kills. And then collapse on these guys' bot, helping out Aatrox before he dies. No, sorry, that was Karma. Aatrox is already dead. And then we're able to get another inhib or end the game. I choose the inhib because it's more guaranteed. And then hook onto Lee. I'm just trying to deal some damage. Now that I've got a little bit of armor, I'm able to tank the turrets. And so I do that so we can take one, and then we take another with Demolish. And then, yeah. Kill her. Kill the Nexus. And that is a game. I might not achieve too much, but I think I was usually at the right place at the right time. Seeing as we won from a disadvantage while the enemy has a fed Vayne and a, you know, fairly fed Mordekaiser, I'd say we did pretty well. I'd say I did pretty well. Leave any comments below about what did I do well, and what would you like to see next. Subscribe if you want to see another one, you know, tomorrow, probably. I'll try to keep that up as long as I can. And let me know if you enjoyed it by leaving a like. But until the next video, see ya.